Hello there, my formerly loyal battle brothers, and welcome to your weekly dose of the Space Marine Chapter's lore. Today we're gonna cover a chapter, a canon chapter, that is, which I was actually certain I already talked about. The reason I'm mentioning that is because the chapter we're starting today is none other than the Astral Claws. Now, some of the stuff you're gonna hear here, you probably already heard in my Badab War series. But if you haven't watched that one yet, I think you're gonna still find this episode informative and, why not, entertaining. I'm your host, the Grimdark Narrator, and without further ado, let us proceed, shall we? So, the Astral Claws. Nowadays, the Astral Claws is a name that is vilified in the Imperium, a name almost synonymous with infamy and treachery. Only just slightly less infamous than the likes of Horus and Abaddon. Maybe, in time, it is also a name that will eventually be wiped from history altogether. But it was not always so. For more than 5 millennia, the Astral Claws chapter would stand shoulder to shoulder with the greatest warriors of the Imperium, and their deeds were legendary, and their honor was unquestioned. It was their glorious record of exemplary service that won them the singular honor of the overall command of the Maelstrom Order Force when they were assigned to the Badab sector in 587 and 41. Luft Huran would rise to prominence, and he would lead the chapter in 697 and 41. It is remarkable to Imperial scholars that just one man, even one as extraordinary and powerful and gifted in command as Luft Huran, could bring so mighty and loyal a force to the brink of heresy and rebellion. Nevertheless, he was the one to do it. Although, if you come to think of it, there's many other formerly loyal chapters who fell to chaos, and their leaders were far inferior to Huran. Some argue that Huran was no more than the result of the chapter's arrogance and self-importance, and that a man like him would have never been allowed to rise to command in another chapter. Nor would any other chapter follow him so carelessly and knowing into damnation. But let us start a bit earlier. The Astral Claws chapter is believed to have been part of the 10th Founding, although some sources differ on this. Created among the dark times of the Nova Terra Interregnum, few records remain surrounding the Founding, which was believed to have been initiated to counteract the rapid erosion and contraction of the Imperial borders during that period. The few surviving records related to the Astral Claws of that period describe them as a crusading chapter, dispatched from war zone to battle the enemies of humanity. Evidence of their presence can be found in the Departamento Minitorum records relating to the Perfidian Wars and the anti-orc purges of Lord Solar Jurastis Macro, while further traces of their exploits can be found on battle shrines relating to their later battles against the Novan Terran forces during the Cataclysm of Souls, which brought the Nova Terra Interregnum to an end. When Abaddon the Despoiler led a great invasion into Imperial space in his fifth Black Crusade, the Astral Claws were there to help defend Cadia in 723 M36. For those valiant efforts, the chapter was awarded one of the greatest accolades a Space Marine could ever get. Their standard was displayed in the Hallway of Heroes before the Eternity Gate in the Imperial Palace. Following the aftermath of the Occlusiad War, the Taninim Crusade was undertaken by the Imperium to gain control of regions on the northwestern fringe of the Segmentum Obscurus. During this crusade, from 678 to 714 M37, 11 Space Marine chapters were sent into the region known as the Taninim Expanse, which extended past the outer edge of known space. They were sent there to identify, target, and destroy any emerging threats which could be found there. Some of the chapters that were sent into the Expanse never returned, while one, the Stormcallers, infamously fell to chaos and civil war within its own ranks. Over time, some of those chapters were never heard from again, regardless of whether they turned into heretics or not. For much of the 37th and 38th millennia, the Astral Claws appear to have confined their range of operation to the Segmentum Obscurus. Their deeds are mentioned repeatedly in the Apocrypha Kali, a valuable historical resource compiled by and still held in the Great Scholastica Corpus on Cypramundi. This details the turbulent events of the Occlusiad War and its aftermath. This work describes the turbulent events of the Occlusiad War and its aftermath. The Apocrypha further mentions that the Astral Claws had three sons, which likely implies that they had three successor chapters out of their ranks, which by itself would be remarkable if it was true, given their relative youth as a chapter at the time, and, if so, a testament to the high regard in which they were held. Matters seem to have taken a darker turn for the chapter in the early 38th millennium, as the Astral Claws were reportedly destroyed in action during the Altid Crusade, while fighting alongside the Dark Angels in 288 M38. It was not until the fall of the Gorgon Pentarchy, 18 centuries later, that the Astral Claws were once again reported as fighting at full strength, with some mention of them undertaking a penitent crusade in between. Their war record for the 39th and 40th millennia records that the Astral Claws were a fleet-based crusading chapter again, ranging within the Segmentum Solar and the Segmentum Tempestus, responding to emergencies and adding their might to ongoing conflicts, often tipping them in the Imperium's favor. Some commentators at the time accused the chapter of a great lust for glory, much greater than the rewards of duty. One particular action by the Astral Claws, which was to have unforeseen repercussions, was the relief of the besieged Executioner chapter at Stygia Aquilon. This battle would create a blood debt between the two chapters that Luft Huron would later call upon to gain the Executioner's aid during the Badab War. It was in recognition to all their service that the High Lords of Terra named the Astral Claws to the Maelstrom Warders, and entrusted them with the leadership of that force. The Maelstrom Warders, if you don't know, were a group of Space Marine chapters dedicated to the defense of the region called the Maelstrom Zone from the Ultima Segmentum. During this period at Badab Primaris, the chapter would thrive, taking to the leadership of the Badab sector with skill and diligence. They used the production capacity of their new world and the connection to the isolated forge world of Angstrom to augment their abilities and increase their capacity for war. The Astral Claws was also one of the chapters able to crusade into the expanse for more than four decades, and return relatively unscathed by the experience. Upon returning to the Imperium, they were awarded the Scepter of Victory at the Segmentum capital planet of Cypramundi, in recognition of their deeds, and also a temple to the Emperor in their honor, which was raised on the shrine world of Picentos to commemorate the action. It was in 680 M41, far distant from the Maelstrom Zone, that a sequence of events was initiated, which was to have dreadful ramifications for the Astral Claws. A ship called the Bakasura, a strike cruiser belonging to the Tiger Claws, reappeared on the edge of the Segmentum Pacificus, containing over 100 battle brothers of a chapter declared extinct over 14 centuries earlier. The ship appeared to have been subject to severe time distortion in the warp, and for those on board, it had seemed that just a few months had passed. After making contact with the Stormwings chapter and aiding them in battle against the Dark Eldar, the Tiger Claws were resupplied and made their way back to the location of their homeworld on Kroda. There, they found that in their long absence, the sun of the system had expanded and turned their world into a lifeless, irradiated husk. Their chapter was nothing more than a legend now. Captain Vetala of the Tiger Claws was now the chapter master, and he would travel to Terra to petition for the release of the chapter Geneseed and the right to rebuild the Tiger Claws. But Captain Vetala disappeared without a trace while awaiting his petition's hearing, and as a result, his suit was dismissed. Rumors in inquisitorial circles hinted that the Lost Chapter was considered heretical by some, and the fact that they were part of the so-called Cursed Founding didn't help them one bit. Their ship, the Bakasura, was last seen conducting operations in the region of their chapter's dead homeworld, and it couldn't be located by the ships sent to the area to track them down. Fast forward a couple of centuries, the hubris of the Astral Claws resulted in their chapter secretly absorbing the remnants of the Tiger Claws, and ultimately leading to Luftharan's dreams of expanding the chapter into a force with the strength of the legions of old. Of course, only to pacify the Maelstrom and crush the enemies of humanity. Or so they thought initially. Some Imperial scholars contend that when the last remaining Tiger Claw survivors were taken into the Astral Claws, the once loyal chapter grabbed the poisonous viper to their hearts, thus causing them to eventually fall from grace. And this, my friends, has been what I wanted to tell you about the Astral Claws and their early history for today. I gotta say, I don't think I've ever heard this theory before, that the Tiger Claws were actually the corrupted ones that turned the Astral Claws to chaos. I still believe, though, that Huron was far too ambitious and a megalomaniac to boot, and the result would have always been the same regardless. This is also not the only episode I'll make on them, so do stay tuned for more on their former organization, specialists, and other important characters which were not Huron. What about you, though? What are your thoughts on the formerly loyal chapter? Do share them in the comments below. If you found the episode informative or entertaining, please click the like, share, and subscribe buttons for future content. Thanks a lot for watching, and the Emperor protects.